Hey guys, I'm Kalila Reynolds, and it's time again for Money Mondays, brought to you in partnership with Proven Wealth. Well, today I want to share with you five things I've learned about money, and some of these have been relatively new lessons. Number one, and this is a big one, don't rely on a single source of income. Unfortunately, for most of my adult life, I did just that because of what I was taught, what most of us are taught. You go to school, you grow up, you get a job. But then we grow up and we do those things and quickly realize it's not enough, right? You're working and it's like you just can't make ends meet, especially if you have kids. So I did what a lot of people do. I got a second job because in my mind, that's how you make more money. You go to work and someone pays you. It took me a long time to realize that there are other ways and you can have multiple streams of income without working multiple jobs if you simply let your money work for you rather than busting your tail working for money. And one way to do this is through investments, stocks, bonds, rentals, etc. You can watch my episode on generational wealth for more on this. And this way too, if one source of income is late or doesn't come through that month, you're not in a bind to pay your bills because you have other things to carry you through. Number two, delay gratification. Gosh, this is another big one that I can't stress enough. You see something and you want it now. And these marketers are very clever in creating the urgency in your mind to make you believe you have to have this item. No, because it's on sale and there won't be another big sale like this. Well, guess what? There's always another sale. So don't go putting it on a credit card if you don't actually have the money to pay for the item in full at the end of the month when the bill comes. Otherwise, you end up paying interest. And FYI, the lowest credit card interest rate in Jamaica right now is around 49%. Crazy, right? But what's even crazier is you paying it and falling into the debt trap. Trust me, I've been there. It's not pretty. If you don't have the money for something now, just delay gratification. And sometimes even if you do have the money, I find it useful to put it on our wish list and just leave it there for at least a week. At the end of the week, most of the time, I forget about it, which means it wasn't that important in the first place. I didn't absolutely need it. Or I go back and I realize I didn't like it as much as I thought I did. Or something actually important pops up between the time I put the item on hold and the time I intended to buy it. And I'm grateful I didn't spend that money after all. Delaying gratification can help us make better financial decisions. Now, number three. And this goes hand in hand with number two. It's having patience. This is especially important for new investors who like to see a quick return. Now, nothing's wrong with a quick turnaround, particularly if you need money urgently. But if you can afford to wait a bit, you'll often find that you can make an even better return. The secret to wealth isn't some special formula only known by Lodge Hall Brothers and the Illuminati. It's simply patience, investing for the long term. In a recent episode of Money Mondays about recessions, I spoke about how a recession could be a time to get a good deal on company stocks or even real estate because prices are low and most things will rebound eventually. But you still have to choose wisely. You might have to wait a few years for your return, but when it comes, oh, it comes. Just look at the economic turnaround in Jamaica since 2008. Virtually any asset you bought in 08 is now worth exponentially more. And I know 11 years is a long time to wait, but this is how millionaires think. And even on a smaller scale, a lot of people message me about this. You see your stock go down by whatever amount in a week, and then you panic and you sell. And then next week, it's back up and you regret it. Have a little patience. It's best to assess performance over time, several months to a year, and then make a rational rather than an impulsive decision. So number four, have a partner. Have a designated person with whom you consult when you make certain financial decisions. You may want to set a dollar amount for this. So let's say the purchase is over 10,000 Jamaican dollars, about 135 US. Whenever you're about to spend that amount or more on anything, you check in with that person, kind of like an accountability partner for spending. And of course, you want to choose a level-headed person, not someone who you know is going to encourage you to spend on foolishness. Could be a parent, parent, best friend, sibling, spouse, someone you trust to steer you in the right direction. I find it very useful being able to get my husband's opinion on certain things, and I'm glad that we have each other to bounce ideas off on, especially when it comes to investments. We have to both agree on whether to buy something or whether it's time to sell, and we don't always agree, which means that that thing won't be done. I find it's much better to have someone to talk to about money rather than trying to go it alone. And guess what? If you feel like you don't have anyone reliable and knowledgeable enough in your life, there's an entire community on Twitter that you can turn to. So no excuses. And here's number five. I first learned this one from Oprah, but it's a very popular principle. Pay yourself first. Set up a salary deduction that goes directly into a savings account or an investment account so that you never really have to miss that money. If you wait until you've paid all your bills and met all your expenses and just use whatever is left over to save or invest, you'll never have enough to save or invest. But if you do that first, before paying anyone else, you prioritize your financial goals. Now, paying yourself first doesn't mean treating yourself to something nice before paying your bills, then realizing you don't have enough left to pay your bills. Paying yourself first means putting your financial future first, setting yourself up for positive returns, and growing your money. So these are some of my hard-learned money lessons, some of which, honestly, I'm still learning, but I'm getting better. And I hope this helps you today on your own journey to wealth. That's it for this edition of Money Mondays, brought to you in partnership with Proven Wealth. I'm Kalila Reynolds. Make sure to like this video and comment below. What lesson did you most relate to? Share with a friend and subscribe to my pages and channels. See you next week.